Hey, are you wondering if Thornton, Colorado is a good place to live? Well, that's exactly what this video is for. Let's get started. All right, hi again. It's Kristy Lee here, and I am a local real estate agent in Colorado. And my videos specialize on my favorite places to live, my favorite places to take my kid, restaurants, shopping, and all of that good stuff. So today we're gonna be focusing more on Thornton, Colorado, and whether or not it's a good place to live, you know, things to do in this area. So if that's something that interests you, please click subscribe right there. That way you get notified every time I have a new video that piques your interest. So anyways, so Thornton, Colorado, in my opinion, I have mixed emotions about. It's not usually on my high top list that I like, mainly because there's parts of it that are kind of run down, definitely lower income areas, but then there's also other areas of Thornton that I absolutely love, and those are the parts that I want to mainly specialize in talking about today. So when you're thinking about moving to Thornton, what I would say is kind of cater your search from 120th and I-25 and head north. And Thornton goes to about 166th area and I-25. So all of those areas are gonna be a little bit nicer areas. I would say built in late 80s and then going up to newer builds right now. The average house price in this area in Thornton is going to be the mid 400s, and then obviously you could go up to, you know, well into the 900 plus range. But once you start getting below the 120th, so, and if you get into 104th or even 92nd area, those are going to be definitely the small homes, like Old Thornton. They're going to be really, really small, lower income, a little bit more shabby of a house. So those kind of areas. So just kind of be aware of what part of Thornton you're actually looking into if you're thinking about moving here. That being said, things that I do love about Thornton is one, the affordability. Like I just said, you could get a great house in here in Thornton for, you know, mid 400s. So Thornton's just located about 15 miles outside of Denver, north of Denver. So, you know, the median price in Denver is mid 600s. So, I mean, you just, if you just went out just a few miles, you could get a much bigger house, much more affordable house than if you were to live in Denver. So that's one great thing. Also, I really like that the growth that Thornton is now offering, especially once you start getting into the northern side. Amazon, the distribution center, is in Thornton now. So that offers a lot of jobs. That's bringing a lot of people into the area, which is great. So a lot of new growth out here. You have the outlet malls, which is off of I-25 and 44th. So you're gonna have that. So that too offers a lot of great jobs, great shopping, things like that. You have Top Golf, which is just even a little bit farther north. And then as well as IKEA. IKEA is not there yet, but IKEA is going up on Highway 7 and I-25. Now that considered is not necessarily Thornton, but it's right there on the cusp of it. And so it's kind of like Thornton, Broomfield area. And IKEA is actually gonna be going there. They've been talking about that for a couple years now. So that's something to look forward to too. Another great thing that I really like about Thornton is that we finally got the light rail coming up north. So the farthest north that the light rail actually comes is 124th, which is in Thornton, which is great. So you could come live anywhere in this area, you know, hop on the light rail on 124th and take that down to Denver. You could take it out to DIA. You could take it out to, you know, Red Rocks out in Golden or Morrison. So, I mean, it does have the accessibility. We are right off of I-25. So getting down to Denver is a piece of cake. Technically it's a piece of cake because it's a straight shot into Denver, so that's going to technically take you maybe 25-30 minutes. However, you know, I-25 is notorious for being back-to-back traffic, and our traffic in Colorado has just gotten progressively worse. So just kind of keep that in mind when you're on 25 if you're working in Denver. Even if you're living in Thornton, it is a straight shot, but most likely in the morning and on rush hour coming home, you probably will hit some traffic. But having the, you know, accessibility with the light rail, with the RTD bus system, it is great because you can't get around without a car when you live in this area. One kind of drawback I kind of feel about living in Thornton is the school. So the school district is Adams 12, and you know, they're not as great as some of the other school districts in the area, like Boulder County, Cherry Creek. So, you know, if that's something that's really of interest to you, if you're a parent and wanting to get your kids into schools, you know, definitely look into Adams County or Adams 12 and see if that's something that interests you. You know, as a parent, I like this area. You know, I have friends who are teachers are in, you know, Adams 12 and they swear by it. But I mean, the testing and stuff like that just doesn't show as much as, you know, some of the other districts in the area. That being said though, if you're not a parent or if, you know, school districts are not even relevant to you, living in this area is going to be fantastic because of the affordability. You know, you could get a house, like I said, in the mid 400s and, you know, not even have to worry about school districts. The one thing I will say about, which is ironic about Thornton, is that while the house prices are lower, the rental prices are higher. So it is kind of a, you know, a catch 22 right there. So if you're wanting to move to this area, just kind of keep that in mind. The rental prices, if you want to rent in this area, is going to be a lot higher than Denver, ironically, but you could purchase a house that's less expensive, excuse me. All right, like anywhere before you move, you should always look into how much taxes are going to be in that area if you were to purchase a house, the yearly taxes. And you know, Thornton, there's parts of it that are going to be lower, but definitely the more north you're going to go, you're going to have a little bit more expensive or more higher taxes. And that's just because you're going to have the newer builds, the newer areas, things that haven't been essentially established yet. So they are just trying to still establish the taxes that are going to be going on yearly. I will say, you know, once you start getting up into like 144th going up to about 166, those new areas are going to be a lot more, you know, anywhere between 5,000 to 6,500 in yearly taxes. So you have to think about that when you're purchasing your house, because that obviously does go on to your monthly mortgage on what you're going to be paying. So if you're trying to budget how much you're going to want to pay for a house or your monthly payment, just take note of what those taxes are going to be in that area. And Thornton, because it is so, you know, wide, and it's going to have a lot of the older houses going to be down the southern side of Thornton, and then the newer houses are going to be on the new northern side of Thornton, they're going to distinguish, you know, greatly on the amount of taxes that you're going to be paying. So definitely keep that in mind. But overall, I would say, you know, Thornton has gotten a lot better over the years. Again, I have grown up in Colorado. I have actually lived in Thornton as well. And, you know, it's never been a place that I've always, you know, gravitated to. But that being said, now that it's gotten a lot newer and it's expanded a lot, you know, farther north, we have, you know, the outlet malls, Topgolf, Cabela's, all of that kind of stuff that's all going up north. It's making it a lot more appealing to people, I feel like. People who are moving here, you could get a newer house that's less expensive and still have the amenities that some of the, you know, the communities down south like Parker and Highlands Ranch that have to offer. We are now finally getting that up north too, so which is really, really great. There's a lot of things to do out here too. You are super close to Boulder. I would say you're about 30 minutes to Boulder, so that's awesome. You could get to DIA off of, you know, C-470, you could get to DIA in 25 minutes. So if you work out in the airport, or if you're just taking a trip, that's super quick out there. Brighton is really close. In Thornton, if you want some land, some acreage, you could get out some acreage out here too. So a lot of people kind of forget about that because they think of Thornton more of like a compact city. And actually, once you start getting a little bit more north, it actually butts up right against Brighton. And so there's a lot of communities out there that actually offer, you know, the little bit of acreage. You could get an outbuilding out there. So it's just something to think about, because most people just, you know, compartmentalize that Thornton is just going to be this really tight city. And actually it has a lot of places that are a little bit more spread out. So that's cool too. Okay, that's Thornton in a nutshell, or at least my opinion of Thornton in a nutshell. Would I personally move to Thornton? Yes and no. I would move to parts of Thornton. So again, if Thornton is kind of on your radar, please reach out to me because I would love to guide you to the specific parts that I think are going to be amazing and probably that are going to fit your lifestyle. Again, I am a local real estate agent and I love helping people move to Colorado or helping people move within Colorado. So please reach out to me anytime. I am the one that answers the phone and the text messages. Click that subscribe button right there so you get notified every time I have a new video. And to the next one. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.